And so Najashi calls them a second time and say, Najashi ibn Abi Talib, the first thing that he narrates, he selected certain ayat from Surah Maryam, which talk about Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam, his position with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Najashi, he listens to these words, and he listens to these verses, and then he testifies and he says that these verses, no other verses except the same ones that were revealed to Sayyidina Isa, to the Prophet Jesus, Prophet Isa alayhi salam, and that no one came to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam except the same one that came to Sayyidina Isa with the revelation. So such was Sayyidina Ja'far ibn Abi Talib. And when he returned from Abyssinia to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in Medina, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had just been advised, and they had just had the Fatah of Khaybar, the conquest of Khaybar. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, upon seeing Sayyidina Ja'far ibn Abi Talib, he says, "I don't know what I'm more happy about, بفتح خيبر أم قدوم جعفر جعفر." He says, "I don't know what I'm more happy about. Is it the conquest of Khaybar, in which the Muslims were able to overcome the opponents, or is it the coming back and the return of Ja'far radiallahu ta'ala anhu?" Ja'far, who was the Sahaba used to say, was the one who resembled the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam more than any of the Sahaba, khalqan wa khuluqa. He was the one that resembled the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam more so in his physical attributes and in his khuluq, and his inner qualities, and his manners and his characteristics. The Sayyidina Ja'far ibn Abi Talib was the one who wanted to give his soul fi sabilillah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He was the one who was brought up by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Such he was the one, the second person whom Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam assigned in the battle of Mu'tah. When the Sahaba used to go, a few thousand of them, to battle, to fight against 200,000 of the Romans. 200,000 of the Romans they go, and the Sahaba they go, and there's a small few thousand, and they go to fight. And Sayyidina Ja'far ibn Abi Talib, upon seeing Mus'ab ibn Umayr radiallahu tabarak wa ta'ala anhu, Mus'ab ibn Umayr in the Battle of Uhud, but upon seeing the first of the Sahaba that were given the raya, the banner, in the Battle of Mu'tah, he sees that it was lost from him, and so he goes and he takes the battle, and he becomes the leader in the battle, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, that he will be the second of the leaders, and then he mentioned the third, meaning that all these two and three people will be ma'ruf fi sabilillah in that particular battle. And so Sayyidina Ja'far, he goes and he takes the battle with both his hands, and he's on his horse, and he goes out and he continues fighting, such that he finds that he's unable to protrude into the fields of the enemies. And so what does he do? He leaves his horse in order to go on foot, and he goes into the enemy fields. And so he goes in with his banner and he's fighting and his sword. However, his right hand is cut off. And so he takes his banner with his left hand. And then his left hand is cut off. And so he takes his banner with both his upper arms. And so he has no forearms, no right forearm, no left forearm. And so he takes the banner. He doesn't give up, because he's someone who's sacrificed his entire life and his entire wealth for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, fi sabilillah. And so he takes his upper arms and he hugs the banner. He hugs the banner and he continues fighting. He continues fighting until he's fallen, and the next one of the Sahaba comes and he takes the raya. And at this, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he sees the entire battle before him, before even the battle is finished. And the Sahaba there at Mu'tah, they send one of their emissaries and messengers to go advise the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam of what happened. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam sees the entire battle before him, and he sees Sayyidina Ja'far bin Abi Talib, and he responds, and he is extremely saddened at the death of Sayyidina Ja'far. But he says regarding the reward of Sayyidina Ja'far ibn Abi Talib, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has replaced for his two forearms, two wings in Jannah, which he flies in Jannah, and he is now flying in Jannah, in the heavens of Jannah, in the skies of Jannah, in the paradise, in the gardens of Jannah. These are people who knew what it means to sacrifice for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They were brought up from whilst they were young, fi sabilillah, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his messenger. Whether it was that in front of a room or in front of an enemy on a physical battlefield, it doesn't matter. Whatever the jihad for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is one which is vast in its meanings. And the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum, in any way in which they went, in any path which they took, they would take it fi sabilillah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and their entire seeking of knowledge, and their entire transmission of knowledge, and their entire spending of their charity, and their entire time according to Allah ta'ala and his messenger, was fi sabilillah, as was considered as a reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So such were the young people who grew up in the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so for us youth, for us young people, for us who have children, for us who have brothers, for us who have cousins who are young and still in their youthhood, Let us seek to the examples of the Sahaba, these young Sahaba who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allowed the message of Islam to be erected upon their shoulders. And Mus'ab ibn Umayr, that young man in Mecca, who whenever he used to walk in the path, all the women used to look and glance at him. He used to wear the most expensive clothes of his time in Mecca. His mother used to spoil him. He used to have the most expensive of perfumes and fragrances, the most expensive of clothes. He would not wear nothing except the best, but he left all this. Why? Because he heard that there was a man that was calling to Allah and to the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so he left all this. And so when he was martyred in the battle of Uhud radiallahu ta'ala anhu, the Sahaba, they said, we went to shroud him and we couldn't find except a shroud that if we covered his head, his feet would be exposed. And if we covered his feet, then his head would be exposed. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam remembered that this was a youth who used to prance around and walk around in Mecca with pride and arrogance before Islam, wearing the most expensive of clothes, and there was nothing of the wealth of this dunya except that he had facilitated before him. And he left all this. Why? For Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So this was the sacrifice that the youth had for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us a portion of this sacrifice, that we sacrifice with our families, that we sacrifice with our work, we sacrifice with our youth, we sacrifice with those around us in our time and our wealth and our knowledge for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we try and embody the characteristics and the qualities of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the great noble companions radiallahu ta'ala anhum. And then the third, before we finish, the third and final quality which we'll mention before we close, is the person whose heart is attached to the masajid. الرجل قلبه معلق بالمساجد. A man whose heart is attached to the masajid. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, في بيوت أذن الله أن ترفع ويذكر فيها اسمه يسبح له فيها بالغدو والآصال رجال لا تلهيهم تجارة ولا بيع عن ذكر الله. Allah Tabarak wa ta'ala says, in houses in which Allah Tabarak wa ta'ala has instructed and permitted for His name to be remembered and to be recited, رجال لا تلهيهم. These are men. What are the descriptions of these people who take these houses as their homes? رجال. These are men. They're not males, they're not dhukur, because there's a difference between a dhakar and a rajul. These are rijalun who stand firm on their feet, firm on their principles. They don't compromise. Rijalun la tulhihim tijaratun wala bay'un an dhikrillah. That no trade, no commerce, no buying, no selling will be able to deviate them and to distract them from an dhikrillah, from the remembrance of Allah. Wa iqam as-salah, and performing the prayer. Wa ita'i zakah, and spending in the charity. يَخَافُونَ يَوْمًا تَتَقَلَّبُ فِيهِ الْقُلُوبُ وَالْأَبْصَارُ. They fear a day in which the hearts and the eyes will be overturned. لِيَجْزِيَهُمُ اللَّهُ أَحْسَنَ مَا عَمِلُوا وَيَزِيدَهُمْ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ وَاللَّهُ يَرْزُقُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. And the result, the reward of such people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give them reward for the best things that they do. And the reward for the best things they do will be the reward which is the best with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَيَزِيدَهُمْ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ. And all of this great reward for the good that they have done of their deeds, وَيَزِيدَهُمْ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ. And Allah tabarak wa ta'ala will give them increase from where? From His virtue and from His bounty and from His favor over and above this. وَاللَّهُ يَرْزُقُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. It is not by chance that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala mentions this ayah and this reward, this third degree and this third stage of this reward. After talking about a people, رِجَالٌ لَا تُلْهِيهِمْ تِجَارَةٌ وَلَا بَيْعٌ عَنْ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وَإِقَامِ الصَّلَاةِ وَإِيتَاءِ الزَّكَاةِ. These are people, these are men, whom no trade, no commerce will distract them from the remembrance of Allah and the fulfillment and the erecting of the prayers. And so it is from the masajid that the call arises, Allahu Akbar. You won't find a call other than the masajid. It is in these masajid where the lights of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are being cast. It is in these masajid which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam called us in order to attach our hearts. How do you attach your heart? If you look to the lights and to the chandeliers, if you look to the fans that are connected and they're clinging to the masajid, your heart is to be like these particular physical ornaments within the masjid. Your heart should be attached to the masjid, such that when you leave the masjid, your heart is still attached to the masjid. And mu'allaqun bil masajid, connected to the masajid, when do you have a